Thank you. You've saved this sacred place. This will earn you the blessings of the Mother.
Ah! See, Tolga? Told you it was Crane.
Are you sure? He looks weird.
He always looks weird. Crane, we did it! We flew!
But not with the jetpack.
But we found a plane instead.
Almost in good condition. Had to make a few adjustments to it.
And the gasket broke. All the oil leaked out. The engine seized up.
We had to jump out. But Mr. Dahl, our boss...
Whoosh! He flew all the way to the west. You have to find him, Crane.
But you two actually care about someone else.
Oh, you wound us, Mr. Crane. Also, Mr. Dahl is a billionaire. He'll make us rich.
All right. How am I supposed to find him?
Simple. Mr. Dahl has a transmitter in his backpack. That's our insurance.
You know, in case he tried to screw us over.
Can't trust anyone, you know.
Take that tracking device. The beeping will be faster the closer you are to the transmitter.
And when you get back, we'll tune this tracking device so that you'll be able to find other things. Tolga, tell him.
Everything that's chipped, Crane. And these days, a lot of things are chipped, aren't they? Military equipment, for example.
But first, Mr. Dahl.
Go for it, Crane. You can do it. We believe in you. You have to say things like that to people like him, you know.
Yes, and yes. But the crew were no outsiders, just a few unlucky people trying to get out of Iran.
Did anyone survive? Are they dangerous?
Yeah, two survivors, but no, they're just a pair of suicidal mad scientists. More dangerous to themselves than anyone else.
Scientists, you say? The mother would like you to keep an eye on them, just in case.
Thank you.
signal must be getting close. Warmer. Where are you, doll? Guys, I found Dahl's transmitter.
See, Tolga? Told you he was going to find him. Pay up!
Wait, Crane, is Mr. Dahl all right?
It's hard to say.
Ha! He's dead! You lose, Fatin!
I don't know if he's dead, guys. I just found his backpack. No sign of the man himself. Any ideas?
We're geniuses. Of course we have ideas. We're prepared.
Not that we didn't trust the man, but he has another transmitter in one of his shoes.
Set the tracking device to your second channel and move on with your investigation.
Holy shit! Fucking...
Thank you. Oh.
Mr. Crane, isn't it? You're really something, you know that. Never seen a man earn the trust of the children as fast as you did. They've kept an understandably low profile ever since the government banned all illegal religious sects in our country.
Banned? Why?
There was a massacre 50 years ago. It was chaos after that. We had to act fast, and we had no idea what should be done. It was in politics back then, but not corrupt. Not corrupt. I voted against the madness, but nobody listened. They laughed at me, blamed the children, but I knew they were wrong. My mother grew up here and never had a bad word to say about the children. After I lost everything, I came to this place and helped them start a preservation society of sorts. They kept their rituals a secret, didn't accept anyone from the outside. And for a long time I felt betrayed, Mr. Crane. I helped them survive, and they shut their doors to me. How could they?
They didn't accept you into the group?
No. I'm sure you can imagine how betrayed I felt. But now that the government has failed to protect its people, the children have reappeared, stronger than ever before. And after all those years, they didn't forget about me, Mr. Crane. I'm well fed, clothed, and safe. They provide me with everything I might need. I wish I could say all's well that ends well. I just hope we all live long enough to see the end of this madness.
Thank you.
Hell, you're not Vulcan, doll.
Was I supposed to be?
Where did you get those boots?
Hey, he didn't need them anymore. Lay off!
Did you kill him? Where is he?
Hey, he turned. I killed a monster, not a human.
Shit. Where?
Shot him straight through the head.
No, you idiot. Where is his body?
Oh, not far from here. Listen, I can pay you for these boots if they're so important to you. No problem.
Just forget it. Guys, I found Dahl. Bettine, Tolga, you there? Where'd you go? God damn it.
Help! We're surrounded!
Oh, scream louder, Fatine. Maybe they'll figure out where.
The train! On the bridge! Ah! Go away!
Tell them we have portable photon throwers.
A photon thrower? That's just a flashlight, Tolga!
As if they know what photons are.
Bastards! Tolga, cover me!
With what? A stick? Get away from that door!
Try to clear this place out.
Get them, Crane! Nice man in the right place!
In his natural environment.
Crane, what's taking you so long?
Yes, isn't killing your specialty?
Let's not distract him or he'll shoot himself in the foot.
Yes, right. Focus, Crane! For the win! Something that will inspire you.
I read up, Tolga!
fuck is making me mad?
It's clear, you can come out.
Now we're in one of these carriages, don't shoot!
Knock three times and we'll let you in.
Tolka, are you crazy? Don't ask him to do math.
That's not the proper knock. Go away.
It's me, fuckers.
Let him in, Fatin. It's him. You were right. He can't count to three.
What the hell are you guys doing in here?
A secret project.
Don't talk about it, Fatin. You know people like him just repeat everything they hear?
But he might be useful later.
Then we'll tell him when he becomes useful.
Maybe we should let him stay here. Proximity to us can only raise his intelligence.
Your generosity is overwhelming, but I believe you promised me something earlier.
You're underestimating us, Crane. We did it remotely, just a moment ago.
Now this device will react to anything that's cheap. And when something's cheap...
Then usually it's pretty valuable. Unless it's your neighbor's dog.
Now let's get down to business, Tolga. Time to start the project. We'll be in touch, Crane. Take care.
what you're doing is right. Soon you will become one of us.
What's up?
We have a new plan. It's brilliant.
We're waiting at the railway tunnel.
Near a gate in the wall. Come and find us.
seen him with his wife up in the mountains.
Oh, please. You've been here this whole fucking time.
I ain't lying, motherfucker. She looked better, like cured, maybe.
Now I know you're lying. Nobody gets their mind back after that kind of shit.
Telling you, man, seen it with my own eyes.
No way. He killed himself. She died. Kid wound up on the streets. Got it in her head she was a witch hunter or some shit.
Who? The second kid?
No, dumbass. The first one.
Yeah, well, no witches around here. Just fucking zombies.
He always drank too much. He got drunk, hit her, she miscarried. Everything went downhill after that.
He didn't kill himself.
You know so much? Then where is he, huh? You gonna lead the way?
In the middle of all this zombie garbage? Are you out of your fucking mind?
Ah, fuck it. Pretty soon we'll be rich. Won't have to worry about him and whether he's dead or alive or whatever.
Yeah? Plan's good. I worry, though. You've heard about this stranger?
Heard about what now?
Some asshole doing all their dirty work for them. If they don't get balls to do something, he steps in.
Guns blazing, huh? Come on. That's superhero bullshit. Grow the fuck up.
That's just what I heard, is all.
Yeah, you heard bullshit.
Jesus Christ! Will you two shut the fuck up already? Some people are trying to sleep here.
We can sleep once this is done, man.
I am gonna sleep now, and you better get some shut-eye too. Who you think's gonna carry all the loot?
Shit. Motherfucker's right.
Okay, just stop whining.
I'll whine your fucking head off when we're done with this.
Shut up, both of you.
Off that flashlight.
All right, Chief. You got it.
But I've seen this uniform before. You're what's left of Ryze's gang, huh?
We're... I don't know. Exactly. They didn't tell me. I just joined.
Quit lying, asshole. What are you fuckers doing out here?
I don't know!
You understand I'm a hair away from killing you, right?
Okay. I'll talk. But all I know is the boss had a plan. Poison the water supply. Loot everybody. We brought some corpses, threw them in the water.
Jesus, you sick bastards. Who's your boss? Where is he?
I don't know. I told you, I just joined. I didn't want to do it, I swear.
Yeah, just following orders. Let's find out what Jazeera has to say about that. See if he's in the mood to hear excuses.
Come on, Chief, don't do it. They'll fucking lynch me. I'm not gonna die. Not like that.
Here, I'm at the pumping station. Send some people here ASAP. And don't let anyone drink this water.
What happened?
Some bandits threw corpses into the water. Clean out the bodies and the water should clear up again. You got that?
Of course. Thank you. We'll take care of it as soon as possible.
Pollard. I'm thinking about heading to Erkan's farm.
You're crazy, mister. That's suicide.
Hey, let me be the judge of that. Besides, the bandits might target this place next.
Let them fucking try. After what they did to that girl, there won't be no mercy.
Well, if you feel that way, then why wait? Why not take revenge right now?
Don't get all high and mighty with me, mister. We are angry, true, but we are not crazy. You want to get yourself killed?
I think I can handle some thugs with guns. I heard you might be able to help me. Jazeera said you worked at that farm?
Work there I did, true. If you really do want to go there, follow the wall and go east of the entrance. There's a hole in that high wall. You could probably use it to sneak in.
Hey, Eski, that's Erkan's daughter, right?
No, that's not her. That's what's left of her. She was the happiest person I'd ever known, but now...
I'm sorry, but she's, conscious, right?
Conscious, yes. But the longer she lies there, the more I feel like she just doesn't want to live anymore. When she was still speaking, she told me they hurt her and her mother. They shot her brother in the face, Kyle. Made her watch.
All right, I'll take care of it. They won't hurt anyone else.
Yeah, of course. Sorry. I just think I've heard it too many times before.
You pay for this! go.
Khan,
just kill me. Why? How could they?
Erkan, is that you?
Coward. Kill me.
Hey, Erkan.
What could I do?
Hey, you're safe, man. Get a grip. Your daughter's alive.
Shoot me, please. I want to join them.
Erkan, your daughter is alive. She's at Jazeer's farm. She needs you.
Coward.
For fuck's sake. Jazeer, you there? Look, I don't know how this happened, but Erkan is alive. He's a wreck, though.
Her cat's alive? And you really did get rid of those bandits?
Listen, he doesn't know me, and I can't get through to him. He's in deep shock. Look, the farm's clear, so I don't know. Maybe you could ask your guys to bring him back?
Of course, of course. We'll take care of it. Thank you.
Just as I promised, the bandits are no threat now.
Thank you. You did more for her than anyone else in this godforsaken place.
Look, Eski, I've seen a lot. The only thing I can tell you is eventually it will start to hurt a little less.
Don't patronize me, Kyle. You think she's the only friend I've lost since the outbreak? It's terrible. I'm getting so numb it almost doesn't hurt anymore.
At least this one will get her father back. Erkan's alive. They'll bring him here.
Oh? He survived? Well, I guess she'd have been a little bit happier if only she'd heard that. Though...
Though what?
Nothing much. Just a thought. I just wonder why, before, she told me what happened to everyone else, but didn't say a word about him.
for.
Thank you.
Tolga. I'm near the tunnel. Where'd you say you were?
Really, Crane? Is it not obvious?
Now who's getting him confused, Vadim?
Try to get those synapses firing, Crane.
Congratulations! You made it!
I'd wager you've forgotten about our secret project already, yes?
We're just trying to kickstart it.
Your mind won't be able to comprehend the grandeur of its concept.
And the result will give you a heart attack.
Once it's complete, that is. For now, we just need some junk, metal parts, scraps.
And tape.
And nails. Can you remember all that?
You should take notes.
Better yet, use crayons and draw.
Oh, also, take that Geiger counter with you, in case of radiation. Don't thank us.
Radiation? What radiation?
The army could have left some surprises behind. Fatin, tell him.
Relax, Crane. Just listen to the clicks. And come back to us with all that stuff.
be your friend of. Face me like a man.
Hey, Jazeer, there's a goddamn volatile hive under this hut. Half of Sabbat's stuff ended up down in a cave. I'll check it for those herbs you wanted, but I doubt he's still alive.
That's the end of it, then. Don't you dare go in there yourself. Those hives are certain death.
Wait, I think I heard something. Jazeer about this.
This is what you needed, right?
It is. This'll help a lot.
I'm sorry about your friend.
Thank you. Don't worry. At least we know what happened to him. And it's no shame to die that way.
Probably Dahl. A billionaire. Killed because he had really nice shoes.
Thank you. Yeah.